Today I have three useful Illustrator tools that you probably don't use, or you don't use that often. So let's dive right into today's Illustrator tutorial on three useful tools. The first useful Illustrator tool is the Group Selection tool, which is a time saver and a technical wonder. So I have this design here which is made up of two different vector shapes. I can select both shapes and group them together with Command or Control G. Or you can group them at the very top here. Now these two shapes are grouped together. However, we can duplicate this group with the Alt Option key, making three separate groups. But further still, we can actually group all of the three groups together into one huge group. Having groups inside of groups is essential for some designs, but it can get quite confusing and annoying. How can we edit one aspect of this design group within multiple groups? You might try to use the isolation method where you double click a specific shape. However, you're going to notice that you cannot actually access one shape by itself, as are groups inside of groups. So under the Direct Selection tool, you can find the Group Selection tool. This will allow you to select between multiple groups within groups and access the shapes individually. Click once to select a shape or an object, then click again to highlight that group, and then click again to highlight the larger group. This is super useful as you can quickly access and click between objects in multiple groups, and then edit them thereafter. The next useful Illustrator tool that you probably don't use is not only a time saver, but it can be used in place of the pen tool to create unique shapes. Here we have a vector shape that is just a stroke without a fill, but this tool does work on filled shapes too. The tool we're going to be using now is the Reshape tool, which is here. To use the Reshape tool, we must first select the vector path with the Direct Selection tool, like so. You can then take the Reshape tool and click and drag the vector path anywhere along the shape. This is great for quick edits to shapes when making a design, and each time you use the Reshape tool, it's going to add another anchor point onto the vector path. You can also press A for the Direct Selection tool to edit the anchor points themselves. The normal way people would do something like this would be to add an anchor point with the anchor point tool and then use the Direct Selection tool as well. However, the Reshape tool is a lot faster and allows you easier manipulation of your vector shapes. The last useful Illustrator tool that you might not be using is the Smooth tool. Now this is an awesome tool if you're not amazing with the pen tool, for example this crudely drawn shape here. Whilst the shape is selected with the selection tool, you can locate the Smooth tool here. Now it's just a case of either drawing along the path that you want to smoothen out, or you can click an anchor point to smoothen the entire shape by itself. You can, of course, take the Direct Selection tool and move anchor points around, and then go back and use the Smooth tool again to smoothen out the path. I'm sure you can see that it's obvious how this will be useful when working on tricky or uneven paths in Adobe Illustrator. So there are three useful Illustrator tools that you probably don't use. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video down in the comment section below. Also, if you want to help out my channel here at Satori Graphics, head over to my Teespring store linked in the top right corner, as I have a new typography based t-shirt available right now. I also have other designs there too, so if you want to grab a unique and original shirt, click the card in the corner and help out my channel. I wish you all the very best for the weekend ahead, and thank you so much to all of the regular viewers and people who voiced their opinions and suggestions. I really do appreciate it, guys. But anyway, until next time, design your future today. Peace.